My name is Tony. I'm the co-founder of The Higher Company, and welcome back to What Wax Wednesdays. All right, y'all, so this is another episode in What Wax Wednesdays. In this episode, y'all, the wax that I'm featuring, we're about to see if it's living up to the hype. Like, y'all, this wax is so hyped up. It's always out of stock. I'm even surprised I got it. Spoiler alert, this is the wax that I first wanted to start out with. But y'all, since the time I thought about starting it until now, I just got in it. I think they dropped it once more, but I missed that. I could not get my hands on this wax. I had to look to the next best, which to me was the C3. But anyways, this wax, I don't have my computer in front of me. This wax is Soy 10 from California Candle Supply. Everyone is hyping up this wax, the best cold throw. They're saying it has the best hot throw, smooth tops, blah, blah, blah. So we're about to test this out today. So I got this wax on April 5th and it was delivered on April 20th. So about 2 weeks, and take into consideration that the shipping is only on weekdays. So about 10 days plus a little more, 2 weeks. So just know if you're gonna wanna order this wax, whenever they do start to get it back in stock on a regular basis, it should take about 2 weeks to get to you. So, well, from my experience, let's get straight into the wax details. I got the 45-pound wax, and it came up to $71.55. With shipping, it came up to like $120. So, y'all, this was expensive. Just in case you were wanting to know like the prices. On the website on calcandlesupplies.com, the wax description says Soy 10 is our best performing all-natural container wax. It is a heavy fortified soy blend, meaning it has a harder consistency, better heat resistance, and it can hold larger fragrance loads in comparison to other soy waxes. The wax adheres well and receives color well too, which we will be testing because y'all know in the series I'm gonna do one without color and one with color. It says all natural container blend. I just said all of that. Good color, no additive. It said no additives required. Heavily fortified, buttery consistency. The melt point is 124 to 127 degrees Fahrenheit. The fragrance load is 10 to 12 plus, and the pour temperature is 190. And they just give you like wicks that you could use with the wax. The wick that I'll be using is a CD22. I'm gonna put it up on the screen. I can't remember. I think it's a CD20 or CD22. And then it says, note, Soy 10, like other all-natural waxes, prefer larger wicks for hotter burn profiles. This enables the fragrance to release from the soy more efficiently, as soy tends to lock in oil. We recommend max loads of 12%, especially when working with open flames such as a candle with wick set up. But what I didn't do in my last wax review was push the fragrance load limit in the wax, which I thought about after I had already made the candle. So in this video, I'm gonna push it to the max load, which is 12%. And then they do recommend that you use 12%. So I'm gonna use 12% and see what it's giving. This wax does come in slab form like our last wax. Actually, y'all, I realized all the waxes that I've ordered so far are a slab form, but it does say this one has a buttery consistency, so it could be easier to cut than the last one, but we'll see. All right, y'all, now that we've gone over the specs, we'll hop straight into me opening the package. This will probably be a different setup than the last video because it's over there on the floor because it's very heavy to lift. And I'll probably cut it up and then bring it to y'all on the camera. So let's get into the next portion of the video. Okay, so this is just the paper, and as you see, it came up to $120 and the shipping was about $50. Here is the slab. Wow. It looks like it's about 4 slabs down. I'm not sure if you can see that. And it smells, from opening the package, it smells a bit like coconut oil, but I'm gonna cut into it really quickly and see how the consistency is.
So we have our trusty knife again. I'm gonna start on this side and see. Okay, yeah, this is way softer than the other one. This is how the wax looks straight from cutting it. First impression and texture, it's very buttery, slippery. It smells like coconut oil or something. And as you can see, I guess it got smushed down, I'm not sure. Closer vibe. And then if you see, like, I could literally just press it off. So it says hard, but maybe like I can't do the, oh well. I'm squeezing it as hard as I can, and I could, I guess, do that. So I'm gonna measure it out, and I'm making 2 9-ounce candles to push the limit of the wax. I need 12 ounces, so I only need 448.8 grams of wax. So we'll get into measuring that, and then I'll put it on the stove and y'all can see how it burns. All right, so I have my pouring pitcher, and I'm gonna just tear the scale out. And remember, we need 448.8. So that slab that I just cut is 270. That's 487, so I have to cut a little bit off for this chunk. All right, so I'm gonna put this on the stove and we'll see how fast it melts. So I've got the wax up to 190, or I did it a little higher since the pour temp is 190, and this is the 12% of fragrance oil, and I'm just gonna add that really quickly. One thing you want to consider also, y'all, is the, I think it's called a flash point of your fragrance oil, like putting it into the hot wax, because you don't want to like burn off the scent, I think it's called. And I already did my research. I think this is 200. If it's not, I'll put the like the flash point or whatever it's called on the screen, just so that you know. Okay, and then I'm gonna stir for 2 minutes, of course. Okay, so I've stirred it for 2 minutes. I'm gonna move this out the way. Again, I put it here because it was hot. I have my jars that I whipped already right here. Y'all, I'm trying so hard to get this lighting right because it keeps getting too bright. But whatever, I turned the air off in my apartment so that it's not too cold in here, and I'm gonna pour. So this is the first candle, no mica powder. So I'm just gonna let that sit. Let me put the wick holder on it really quickly. So I'm gonna just push this back a little bit so you can see. And this is the Mica powder color I'll be using. It looks a little orange. I was trying to go for a brownish look, but whatever. Not too sure what the color is. It looks bronze, so I'm gonna add that.
Back with the first impressions review on making the candles. Again, they're sitting in front of me. So first impressions, while using the candle, it melts pretty quickly when it was on the stove, like in the double boiler method. After like washing all of the utensils I use, like the pouring pitcher, the wooden spoon and stuff, the wax is very like greasy type. So usually when I wash my utensils, it's just one wash and it's done. This one, after the first wash, it was still very like greasy, so I had to go back and wash it again. And I used Dawn, and you know Dawn works very good. So I'm interested to see like how that would play into the candle after like it's cured. Also, the color looks like it's taking very well. Again, I did use a lot of color because I couldn't see. I was trying to look into the camera and I was like, wow, I use a lot of color. So maybe it's taking well, or maybe I just use a lot. But we'll see again in 2 weeks how that will work out. And lastly, it looks like it's cooling like the wax that I use, as opposed to the one I reviewed last, which was the beeswax cocoa cream wax. When it cooled on the sides, this one is cooling its way upwards, so that's a positive sign that it won't like cool unevenly. But that's about it I have for the wax. Also, the wax smells, the last thing I wanted to say is the wax has like an oily scent, but not like overpowering, but it does smell like oil, like coconut oil or something. But so far, like by smelling it, it doesn't interfere with the fragrance oil. But again, we'll see in the part 2 review of this wax. So until then, I'll see y'all in the next video. Don't forget to watch our other videos on our channel. I'll link one in the cards above and at the end of this video. And stay tuned for the rest of this series, and I'll see y'all in the next one. Bye.